When Samuel Taylor were a lad, he stood out by his sen. Cos by the time he reached 13, he measured 6'10". He banged his head fair regular like as he come through kitchen door. But that weren't all, cos fully grown, he measured 7'4". Now, his height had always been a problem, the nose, but he were very popular with all his mates. See, when they went scrumping for apples, they'd no need for a ladder or out like that. Old Sam would just reach up into a tree and grab an handful. He had his uses, did old Sam. But Samuel found he couldn't get a regular job at all. Employers didn't like him, cos he made them feel so small. So he went all round the countryside trying to get his son a job, and doing a bit of this and that to make a couple of bob. One day to Castle Donnington on an errand he was sent, and in the marketplace he saw a travelling fairground tent. Outside there were a notice board all painted up and grand, saying, "Come and see the giant, the tallest in the land." It cost the folk a penny to go in and lay a squint, and hundreds of them poured inside, they must have made a mint. Now Samuel, being fairly tall, he wondered what he'd see. But when they fetched this giant out, it was only 6'3". Well, old Sam took one look at this little giant and he fair cracked out laughing. He thought it were a right laugh. He laughed that much he fell off his chair with a plummy great crash. Well, everybody turned round to see who it was making all round. Even showman come up, ready to kick him out. But he soon changed his tune when Sam stood up to dust his ten off. Now when this showman saw out Sam, it made his wallet throb. So little giant got the sack, Samuel got the job. This little bloke went on too chuffed, so he gave out Sam a smack. But he soon wished he hadna when old Samuel thumped him back. So he took this job with travelling show, but after a month or two he got a better offer, so he signed up with this other lot and off he went. They used to tour up and down country, visiting towns and villages alike, and old Samuel had a great time. Well, it wasn't as if he had to do much, it were quite enough for him to just stand there looking tall. And he wrote, "It seems as how this new boss had a daughter who were quite good looking. She had a lovely face like and a great pair of lungs." Well, she were a glass blower, the nose. And he wrote, "Her and Sam sort of took a shine to each other, and eventually they got married and set up a bit of an act together. Her blowing glass and him showing how tall he was. He might have lived to a ripe old age, being lanky like and spry, but at the age of 59 he fell and broke his thigh. They took him into Manchester infirmary straight away, but though they tried they couldn't keep the hounds of death at bay. He wanted to be buried near place where he were born, but he never would have wanted folk to weep for him nor mourn. So a train pulled into Ilkeston, brass band began to play, and people walked along with him and cheered him on his way. So here's to Samuel Taylor, who tried and did his best to conquer his deformity and won